want to boost your high-yielding soybeans to new levels, it may be nitrogen that you're running short on. How to apply nitrogen in soybeans late in the season is the subject of today's Iron Talk. First of all, why would you apply nitrogen to soybeans? Here are a few givens. Nodules in ideal soil and weather conditions can only produce about 70% of your soybeans' nitrogen needs. Organic matter can release roughly 20 pounds of nitrogen per 1% of organic matter, and fertilizer sources like MAP or DAP just don't contain much nitrogen. So let's take this example. If you're shooting for 70 bushel soybeans, they require the uptake of about 305 pounds of nitrogen. Nodules can produce up to about 210, that would be 70%. Now, if soil had 2% organic matter, that would give you another 40 pounds of nitrogen. And if you applied 100 pounds of MAP to meet most of your phosphorus demand, you'd get about 10 more pounds of nitrogen there. So you add all that up, and you're still short 45 pounds for what the crop is going to need. The ideal time to apply nitrogen is so that availability will come in the R3 stage, which is first pod, and later in the season. Prior to R3, only about 10% of a soybean plant's nitrogen uptake has occurred. The challenge as the season goes on, though, is that the crop is big. The solution is either a high-clearance sprayer or a high-clearance spreader. On our farm, we've used some controlled-release urea in strip trials through a spreader. Where nitrogen was the yield-limiting factor in the field, we were able to push yields and get a good return. We've also looked at some liquid nitrogen with a nitrogen stabilizer with a high-clearance sprayer applied alongside the rows. Once nitrogen is spread on the surface, you need some rain or irrigation water to get it into the soil and up through the root system to feed that high-protein soybean seed. There's some promising yield data out there, especially if you have high-yielding soybeans and low organic matter soils. We'll see this year if it pays once again. That's all for today's Iron Talk, and now back to the show.